Very good morning, children. A special good morning to children who are getting graduated and moving on. This reminds me of my graduation days about 20 years ago. I was also in my suit, felt very good, attended all the culturals. They had a good spread of food. I cherished it. At the end of the day, suddenly it dawned on to me, oh God, from tomorrow I will not wear the same uniform every day. Oh God, I will not sit on the same bench. I will not go to the same washroom again. I will not meet the same friends every day, same teachers every day. And so-called a man by then, the way you are, I broke down and started crying. Started crying profusely. And a friend of mine called Karthik consoled me and said, I don't understand why you are so emotional. We are connected. We all know each other's phone number. We all know where we stay. And we all know that we can come to school whenever we wish. It consoled me. And you people are more lucky. You people are more lucky because you have more technology to connect you people. We had only landline wired phone numbers. You people have Facebook, WhatsApp, Twitter, that, this, whatnot. A Chitrakootan will always remain a Chitrakootan. So you're most welcome to come to school anytime. In all our PTMs, exhibitions, school days, any occasion where we open up our school for public, the sweetest thing I witness is the alumni coming back. Even last week in the school day, there were a lot of alumni who were there. So the doors are always open, because once you are a Chitrakootan, you will always remain a Chitrakootan. So you are lucky. You will be connected. Shubha said today morning that this batch was the first batch when I was taking pre-primary. Diksha said now that this batch was the first batch when I started taking first standard. It's a long journey for us too. I'm also very lucky and glad that I could see children growing from the age of 2.5, from their shorts all the way to the pants and now in the suits. It's a nice feeling to see your journey. Very, very lucky, privileged to see your life's beautiful journey of childhood. As pre-primary teachers, primary teachers, high school teachers, it's a different mixed feeling we go through. Yeah, every year a batch will go out, but the batch would have had a huge history which will stay with us for long. It's a nice feeling what we nurse. When the baby bird gets matured with a strong wing, it's the time the bird has to be let out of nest to graduate, to explore the world. And what the bird feels is what we teachers feel. Taking my story forward, I was always an intelligent student who always scored distinction, but never I was a hard worker. Never I worked hard. I wasn't very sincere. Maybe I was intelligent or lucky that I always scored well. And it so happened I got my 10th result. I just saw that I got distinction. I didn't even care to see what my percentage was. I was so careless, so casual. I was happy that I was distinction. And my father took me to a college. And in that college, they looked at my marks card. I had some 85 odd percentage. They said the cutoff in this college is 90%. To find an admission for your son, you will have to pay 10,000 rupees. 10,000 20 years ago was a very, very big sum. First time I saw my father pulling out a bundle of 100 rupee note, it was very big then, and paid for my admission for my PUC. I had never seen my father spending in one go such big sum, not at all on me. I could not stop. I vocalized to my father, if only I knew it would have costed 10,000, I would have worked last 1 month and would have scored easily 90%. I wasn't lucky because I got to know about it after I got the results. I want to share my experience with you guys. You have 1 month left. Your parents have done a lot to you people. And you have 1 month left to pay something back. Easiest way to pay something back by being sincere for this one remaining month in your hand. Use it to best of you. Let my experience help you at least. Going forward, I joined engineering with 8 of my friends. All 8 friends who stayed in the first 2 benches, all joined engineering. Not a single person joined doctor. Not a single person did BSc. Not a single person did BCom, BA, nothing. All engineers of different discipline. None of us knew why we were doing that. None of us had or have any idea why we all became an engineer. Very, very unfortunate. You guys are lucky. You've been oriented about different profiles, professions, disciplines available in this world to succeed. You don't necessarily have to follow the crowd. You don't have to make the same mistake what I did. Look deep inside your inner calling. What is that you want to be? Everybody says all the time, be successful. Yes. But one of the basic necessities of human being is, beyond food, shelter, clothing, is to be happy. That is the very next thing which comes in the priority, to be happy. We all want to be happy. In the journey of life, we trade this happiness for the sake of success. A big tragedy. We trade this happiness for the sake of success. I sincerely hope you don't do. Happy people become successful easily. It's not that successful people are happy. Happy people become successful easily. Graduation is not an end, it's a new start. I wholeheartedly wish you all a happy life, successful life. Enjoy your remaining 1 month of 10th standard. And I would be very, very proud to see you all shine, being happy. God bless you all. Thank you.